Experienced project managers and people who work with ongoing projects will be happy to hear we have a traditional Gantt chart feature in Wrike. A Gantt chart is a timeline of your projects and allows you to schedule your tasks, define durations and dependencies, and build out all the steps visually. The Gantt chart in Wrike has two panels, a table on the left and a timeline of your projects and tasks on the right. This gives you more flexibility working with your projects and tasks. For example, if you schedule a task from your table view, you'll see how the same task will appear in your timeline. Note that only scheduled tasks appear in there, and your backlog tasks look like this. The table works like the table view in Wrike. You can decide which columns you want to see over here using this little gear icon. And you can also filter out unnecessary information from here. Now let's say you need to host a conference. You can see there are a bunch of unassigned and unscheduled tasks. You can assign them right from the table view using the assignee column. And you can hide the columns you don't need right now. Now that all your tasks are assigned, you can schedule them too. You can see that right when you schedule the tasks, they appear in your timeline view. You can define both start and due dates from the table part of the Gantt chart view. Now that you're done with that, you can hide the table view. Now say that right after you choose a place for the event, you need to order food and drinks. That means there's a clear dependency here, and you can define it using this little circle. Just click on the first task and drag it to the beginning of the next task. Now you'll know that you need to start working on this task right after this task is completed. If you need to reschedule dependencies, you can reschedule entire dependency chains in one go using drag and drop. You can also add date constraints that indicate the earliest date a task can begin. Once a date constraint is in place, the task can't be automatically rescheduled to a date prior to the constraint. To create a date constraint, you can use one of the dependent tasks and drag and drop it to the appropriate date. Once you have a date constraint in place, this task will be fixed and won't follow any rules of automatic rescheduling. You can see that some of the tasks, like this one, have this little plus button next to them. That means that this task has subtasks. For example, promote the event over here would have several subtasks that you can see if you click on this button. Subtasks may have different dates, and all of these could be rolled up to the main task. If you want to expand or collapse all items, just use these two buttons. You can also zoom in and out, focusing on just a certain time period. Of course, there may be other stakeholders on such a big project, and you may want to share this information with them. To do that, you can use the Project Snapshot feature over here, or you can print this view out right from the menu button over here. Now you should be pretty comfortable using our Gantt chart for your projects, and we encourage you to do so. As always, feel free to use our help resources, which are available right from your workspace, to look for answers to your questions.